Greetings and hellos to the Bitwig community and beyond. In this video, we'll be taking a closer look at the Bitwig Studio's next actions. Next actions can be very useful when using the Bitwig Studio for live performance, but they can also be very powerful throughout the composition process. They're going to allow us to sketch out the progression of our song without having to commit to the arranger timeline, and this is going to allow us a bit more flexibility and may even yield some happy accidents or unexpected twists. So as you already know, the Bitwig Studio features two sequencers. It features the arranger timeline, which is the linear arranger view, which shows us a musical timeline. And there's also a clip launcher. And the clip launcher can be viewed horizontally or vertically. My preference is usually to work with it vertically. So next actions are going to work with the clip launcher. And they can most simply be explained and described as actions that a clip takes after it plays for a specified amount of time. So in order for next actions to work, we're going to need multiple clips on a track. And when we go ahead and we select a clip, the inspector gives us information about that clip. And if we follow along the inspector on the left, we can see that there is a field for next actions. And there are two fields for next actions. We have do, which is where we decide what next action the clip is going to take. And then we have after, which is where we specify the amount of time that the clip plays for before it takes that next action. I can specify bars, beats, 16th notes, and 100th of a 16th note. And the next action functions are not accessible until we specify an amount of time. So I'm going to go ahead and say 2 bars. Essentially, what I have here is I have a number of different breakbeats, and I want to advance through each of these breakbeats for 2 bars, and then I want it to cycle back to the beginning. So just to let you listen to what they sound like. So when I specify the amount of time, the available next actions are accessible from the list. And by default, it's set to stop for each one, but if I click on the arrow next to it, it brings up the list. And there's a number of next actions, but really what I want to draw your attention to are these main ones here, which is play next, play previous, play first, play last, play random, play other, and round robin. And most of these should be pretty self-explanatory. The play other is a random, but it prevents the one that's currently playing from repeating again. And round robin is just a very fast way to make assignments where it plays successively from one to the next, and then goes back to the beginning. So I can make next action assignments individually for each clip, but I can also select multiple clips at the same time and make next actions very quickly. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and select all of the clips, and I'm going to assign them all to play for 2 bars, and then round robin so that it's going to play through all of them successively and then go back to the beginning. And if we hit the play button here, so in my next example, I've incorporated a bass track, and I have 2 separate bass clips, and essentially what I want them to do is I want them to cycle back and forth over 2 bars while the beat progression plays. So if I go ahead and select the 2 clips, I can set them to 2 bars and then set them to the round robin function again. And if I play this back together with the drum beat and the bass part, now I can get much more elaborate with what the next actions are doing. In this next example, I have what looks to be as blocks of clips across the track. Essentially, what I want to do here is I want to go ahead and make it so that it plays through the progression, but when it goes to do the fill for the last 2 bars of the 8-bar cycle, it randomly picks one of these other beats. And this is where these additional next action functions come into play. So very quickly, I can go ahead and select all of them and make it so that they play for 2 bars apiece, make the length 2 bars. And for the first two here, I'm going to say that their next action should be play the next clip. And the third one here, I will assign to play first in the next block or play random in the next block. Play random in the next block is going to actually play the random one. So on the next block over here, when I have all of these clips selected, the next action that I'm going to assign is play first in the previous block. And this way it'll go back to the beginning. So if I play this back, so very cool, as you can see. So it adds a degree of randomization to it, and you never really know what the fill is going to be. So in this final example, this is kind of everything put together. So I've taken the breakbeat and the fills. I've taken the bass part as well. I've added another clip that's going to provide a downbeat hit that repeats every 2 bars, and I've also added a melody part into this. So the idea with this is that I don't want it to just, you know, I want it to play a progression for how a section, a 32-bar section of the song would work. So you'll notice that I have empty clips for my bass part and for my melody part. And the idea with this, you know, conceptually is that I want it to play through the drum beat first with the hit happening for 8 bars. And then on the next cycle, I want the bass line to come in. So I've created an empty clip, and empty clips can have next actions as well. So this empty clip for the bass track is going to play for 8 bars, and then its next action is that it's going to play the first in the next block, jumping over here. It's going to then play through each of these clips, and it's going to go to an empty clip, and that's where the bass line is going to drop out so that it can do the drum fill. And then for the melody part, I want it to wait 16 bars before it comes in. So I want it to play through the drum beat with the hit, then the bass line, and then have the melody come in. So for the empty clip on the melody track, I have it playing through 16 bars before it goes to the first in the next block. And by the time that it comes in, the bass line has cycled once and it's back to the empty clip. So the melody is going to be by itself and it's going to play through an 8-bar cycle with a fill. The first melody clip plays for 6 bars, and then the second one is 2 bars and it's a fill. And the bass line is going to drop when the melody line repeats. So it's going to be a full 32-bar phrase, and let's give a listen to it to hear what it sounds like. So as you can see, next actions allow you to quickly automate and sketch out sections of your song all by using the clip launcher without having to commit to the arranger timeline. And this is just the tip of the iceberg with what you can do with next actions. So hopefully this has given you some good food for thought, And until next time, get creative. And thanks for listening.